Hello everybody, today's artist is Mr. Sudhir Nayak. I wish to mention here, we have an institution called Dronacharya IAS Academy. It is involved in educational activities. We have classes for candidates who appear for IAS exams, then banking, even 10th, 11th and 12th. This is our new venture, Drona Star Academy, and the other which I mentioned, 10th, 11th, 12th, it's called Drona Guru. And for this Drona Star Academy, we have this idea that we are going to record many of these artists. He may be a potter, he may be a painter, there may be a cook, there may be a sculptor, or there can be a Samadhini player, an artist like you. And we are recording video and audio profiles of all such artists. We want all of you to inspire the young generation, maybe even the older generation, because we have a lot of people who are like 50 plus and 60 plus, and they really are very keen and learning a lot of things. So this is one thing. And as you must have heard, the IAS candidates have one paper, which is art and culture. They study a lot of things, but they really study. They do not know on one-to-one basis what an artist does, how he has lived, how he shaped his life. So, first thing I want to know is the names of your parents, the native town, and a little bit about your childhood.
Okay. Thanks, Nandini, for giving me this opportunity to interact with all those who are interested in becoming a part of Dronacharya Academy. I first of all would like to admit that I am not from a musically literate family.
Okay.
A family which has a musical lineage or a background. My parents belong to the Udupi district of Karnataka, coastal Karnataka.
Okay. My Karnataka. We are also from Karwar.
Yeah. So as you know, it's bountifully blessed by nature.
And when you mention Udupi, I remember that
Shri Garbad. Oh yeah, Garbad ice cream. That's quite a treat there, and people look forward to having that delicacy. All the tourists who come to that
part. Yeah, you were going to mention the names of your parents.
Yeah, my father is Kota Sarvottam Nayak. Kota is the hometown that he belonged to.
Okay.
And later on, he settled down in a place called Hangarkatta, which is also in Udupi district.
Okay.
And my mother comes from a small town called Uppinakote, which is also in Udupi district.
It's a nice tongue twister.
Exactly. It is. Many of the names are like that.
Dhat it dhinda or something.
Something like that.
Something like
yeah.
That.
And fortunately, both of them had an inclination towards music and arts. And that is there with most of the people who belong to that region, because it's, as I said, blessed by nature, and there's so much to learn from nature. Let it be music or art. I feel many of the things come directly to us from nature, and that is why this region in particular has a very long history of arts and music. And also theatre. You must have heard of Yakshagan, which is a very prominent form there. It has folk elements in it, but all the same, there is a classicism to that form too. And there are so many writers, literary people, who have been associated with that region. And so I was lucky to imbibe all this heritage through stories and anecdotes which my father used to tell me.
So then I can ask you, let's say, as a child of one, or as someone who just turned two or just started talking, what was the first memory of music? Let's say some hums or some chirps, or your mom singing some lullaby to you.
To be honest, Nandini, in fact, that was the time when I was not linked to music at all. I mean,
neither music, vocal, neither any other.
Not really, because my mother had a good voice, and she certainly must be singing something.
She has a fine voice. I really have heard that CD of hers. That was on the Mahalsa Geeti.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. She has a good voice. And after marriage, she used to learn from Pramila Datar for a short while. After they shifted to Mumbai, of course.
So you have shifted a couple of residences?
Many in fact. But that was the time.
Were they in Karnataka? Properly staying there?
My parents came from Karnataka. My father shifted to Mumbai in 1961.
Okay.
And then he studied here and then took up a job with Canara Bank.
Mm-hmm.
And then he married my mother. And
it's a curiosity. Was that the time when, suppose he must have gone to see her and then Mulgi gaate ka ek gaana maan, something
no,
like that, did
not
it happen
really,
with
not
her?
Not really, I don't think so, because that is
and
what...
And you translate it.
In fact, you know, music
this particular came, dialogue, you have your own ways.
I don't know much
so
about
when,
their association.
What I'm saying is, when his father must have gone to see the girl,
yeah.
So I said that, did he ask one of the uncles or aunts, does she sing? This is what I wanted to know, and then he answered.
I really don't know. But all the same, my father had an affinity for music, but interestingly, I tell you one anecdote. Which was the first time he listened to a classical concert. It was a Carnatic classical concert, and he heard it in school. And he had a friend called Ismail,
mm-hmm.
and they both had been to that classical concert.
Mm-hmm.
And as luck would have had it, you know, after that concert, somehow both of them fell asleep, and all the authorities, the staff, left for home, and they had the place locked. Except for one window.
Okay.
And
it's quite a tale.
Yeah, and they got up in the midst of darkness, and then they realized that the concert was over, and then they got out from the window, and then there was a forest that was there, and they could not search their path back home, and finally
I thought of making a short film on that.
I think we should. But let me tell you, mustering courage, they went out, and then finally they could see the first rays of the sun. So this is what my father told about his first experience of listening to music. But then later on, he had an attraction for music. But interestingly, what happened was...
And when did your mom start teaching also?
Yeah, that is what I am coming to. Uh-huh. When he came to Mumbai... The most interesting thing was many of his batchmates used to go to films, because film was a big thing in Mumbai, as you know. But my father differed, he thought of going to musical theater,
okay.
Marathi musical dramas, which were in the boom during those times, and some of his colleagues were interested in that. And when he saw one of the productions, he was so impressed. He does not speak Marathi, good Marathi, even today.
The lengthy ones at that time.
Yeah, the lengthy ones. And I mean...
What they say, not even teen anki, more than that.
Yeah.
Not 3x.
That's true. And the best part was, I mean, I don't know whether it was best during that time, because people had a very good taste of music.
Yeah, they used to run overnight, I think.
Overnight and...
Until morning, people would be very sad when it ended.
Exactly. And another good thing in that was, from the musical angle, between every two or three dialogues, there was one song interspersed. I mean, a listener of today...
And the lovely hand gestures.
Yeah, but a listener of today could not have taken that much.
Yes.
But
yes.
Interestingly, my father, he somehow was so much attracted towards that form.
You can say he must have absorbed most of it.
Yeah. He
was
trying
to... just listen to it.
He was listening to the compositions. But at the same time, he appreciated the dialogues also, because finally, Konkani, the language which we speak, is somehow has a connection with Marathi. It's a dialect, some people say, and it's a different improvised form of Marathi.
Like the word gomte.
Many of the words.
Yes, yes.
So he could relate to that. And
has he ever found out some connection? Like, we know there are some tunes that come from Karnataka.
I really don't know.
Some songs.
I really don't know. But when I discuss it with him or my mother now, we find that there are some connections.
Mm-hmm.
From,
mm-hmm.
Because originally, many of the compositions on Marathi stage were like borrowed from Kannada musicals. So there has been an exchange, that is true. So finally, when he started getting interested in these forms, he thought he should teach my mother Natya Sangeet. I mean, he should employ someone who could teach her Natya Sangeet.
Okay.
That is how we came in contact with my Guruji Pandit Tulsidas Borkar later.
Yeah.
But before that, my mother started learning Hindustani classical from one Pandit Madhukar Samant in Goregaon.
And that was which gharana?
That he was not attached to one gharana, but he had a very good voice. He was also a film director, music director for films.
Mm-hmm.
And he was a versatile performer. He could play so many instruments at
one
time.
I think when people used to say ladies should not be doing this and that, your father has been so encouraging.
My father was very much encouraging in that. In fact, he is the one who encouraged all of us to, me to take up a career in music. So that was really generous.
So how little were you when you really started, you know, like, so she's singing and you peep inside and see what exactly is going on.
In fact, I should admit that there was no such situation because I came in contact with music, so to say, only when I was 11. Before that, I was in Uttar Pradesh.
Okay.
And I spent my childhood in Uttar Pradesh because my father was a banker.
Uh-huh.
He used to work with Canara Bank and he
uh-huh.
got transferred to Uttar Pradesh, UP,
okay.
Dehat in Uttar Pradesh, which is called Vijaygarh in
okay.
Aligarh district. And then we used to stay in Firozabad.
So
for
now
some
we
time.
Know where you get all that mimicry from.
But the only music that I used to listen to was Behrupias. We used to go there here and there. And of course, music from folk music.
Behrupia is assuming different.
Yeah, different posture, dress sense. And
outfits.
Then,
and a lot of makeup.
Yeah.
And
different
masks.
Outfits and then. Going about, I remember all
and modifying
the,
voices.
Yeah.
Is
all
that
children,
a single person doing all this?
Yeah, single person.
Okay.
Yeah. Many times single persons, so single people. Otherwise, there used to be
without
groups
any
also doing
music
it.
Or anything.
No.
Just
rarely there was music.
And this person will be throwing dialogues and also singing and lot of things together.
Even their presence was more than enough. I remember children just getting crazy about Kali Devi who used
okay.
to come there. Then again, of course, Ramlila was one big event where I used
okay.
to listen to some music. But I really have faint memories of
was that the time when Ramlila always had characters like a male fellow taking a...
Yeah, that was predominantly
female.
The scene.
Yeah.
Male characters would enact female.
And the interesting part would be that I've heard that there were a lot of males. People would say that this lady doesn't know how to... इसे शर्माना नहीं आता है, look at that person, वो कैसे शर्माता है?
Yeah, I mean, there were so many instances.
In between, I'm going to say these things and you can translate that in a funny way if you wish to.
I won't see, because we have very less time to cover, I'll just go through because there are so many other anecdotes that...
Then I want to know, in your school days, what all happened? When did music come into it? Were there some gatherings? Did you have some favorite teachers?
In
you
fact,
sing? Because you do sing.
I don't sing as much. I mean, people can't tolerate me if
I
sing.
As far as it is in tune.
Certainly, my wife tolerates me if I sing, but I don't know of anyone else. I try to sing myself, although I don't have a very good voice as such. But I do sing to explain music to my students or to some person who wants to sing my composition.
So one thing I just remember, I think you had mentioned once that you used to play tabla when Guruji used to teach or something.
That is what I'm coming to.
So
it.
You have learned tabla?
So that is the story I was coming to, So in fact, we shifted to Mumbai in 79. And from there, we were in Wadala. And
around
then
when you were 7?
I was then 7 years old. Yeah. And then from there, we shifted to Jogeshwari, where actually I got exposed to music from the same guru as I mentioned, Pandit Madhukar Samant. Because his class, in fact, it was a typical class situation. This was when I was 11 years old, in 83. And my brother was sent there to learn tabla because he was a typical... He's younger to me. And he was a mischievous character and my father wanted him to... learn something which would really be...
You are trying to say you are not mischievous.
I don't know. Someone else should
say
sometimes
that. Sometimes people should see you mimicking and telling jokes. Okay.
So he was made to learn tabla.
Okay.
And my father had imagined that he would play tabla with my mother sometime. And that was his vision. And I was purely told to continue my academics.
The quiet Sharif.
Yeah, exactly. I was quite obedient during that time. And suddenly my father saw that my brother is not doing so much, not pursuing it as a serious subject. So he told me, why don't you also learn the tabla? So both of us, Satish, my brother.
So how was it? You happily went or said, okay, now he's
saying. We were fine. It was something that, some new experience for us, and we were ready to do that. And the best part at Madhukar Samanji's class was that we had different sounds to watch, to listen to.
Okay.
We could see someone playing the mandolin. We could see
you
someone.
Had all those instruments.
All
in that
those
class.
Instruments in the class, and Madhukar Samanji.
All the instruments.
Yeah, he used to play all those instruments. He was
a
very versatile.
What all instruments you?
There was the sitar. There was the tabla. There was harmonium. There was of course vocals. Then.
It's a good thing for a
mandolin.
Sir who creates good foundation to know so many instruments.
Exactly. His class was like. Students used to come to the class and learn the basics of so many instruments, even vocal music. He had an excellent voice. Any instrument
old
that
he must
he
be now?
He's passed away, unfortunately. He was 85 when he passed away.
Okay.
The best part about Samant Guruji was when he used to hold any instrument, you know, it would sound so good. It had an immediate response that was created from the listener. And that was his quality.
So how long you took to pick up the tabla, haat, basana, whatever we say?
I don't really.
So that bowls can be identified, that this is dha, this is dhin, whatever. For
that
listener.
That of course we could
maybe
in our own way, but I don't think so. We could play the basic theka, but I really don't know how good we
were. What about instruments? When did you buy the first harmonium, whatever, for your mother?
During that time, precisely the same time.
You must have
same
bought
year,
the harmonium and the tabla.
Yeah. The harmonium
so you
and
had
the tabla.
Fewer things at home.
And the tanpura, yeah. And that is the time when
just a curiosity, what must be the cost of a tanpura at that time?
It was 800 rupees, I distinctly remember that.
So that must be which year, because even I got a tanpura for 800.
1983.
Okay, yeah. Now, yeah.
And then suddenly I could see my mother playing the harmonium, and that was when I thought of, you know,
and
slowly
that was
grabbing.
What kind of harmonium?
It was a regular, you call it a comb-dandli harmonium, horizontally placed reed structure.
So and with the what do you say, bellow?
The regular bellow
on one side.
On both sides.
Both sides
open. So
and she was quite good.
She was trying to pick it up. I won't say she was good.
And you all used to play with her.
We used to try to play the tabla with her when she sang.
When did Guruji come into picture?
It so happened that my father wanted to teach my mother Natya Sangeet from a very good guru. So he was in the lookout for that, and Pandit Omkarnath Gulwadi, a very renowned tabla maestro, he used to work with my father at Canara Bank. And that was the precise time when he discussed this subject with him, and he said, you cannot find a better guru than Pandit Tulsidas Borkar, who is the authority on Natya Sangeet.
And who knows the stylistics of most of the singers.
Exactly, having played with...
Not just actor singers, but singers who just sing Natya Sangeet.
Exactly. And as you know, he had accompanied the Marathi theatre for more than 30 years. Then.
Uncountable, yeah.
Exactly. So
just tell me, what was the first entry you remember that he has come, and what was the dialogue and what was the scene?
I don't really remember that, but to be honest, I saw him once. The first time I saw him was accompanying Pandit Prabhakar Karikar ji.
He was being also quite younger than whatever.
Of
many
course,
many years back.
Of course, yeah. This was in
30 years back.
Yeah,
30
years back. Around 30
okay.
years back. So more than 30 years back, in fact. So Pandit Prabhakar Karikar was singing in IB Patel College in IB Patel School in Goregaon West, and I was listening to it.
Do you still remember Guruji has this habit of giving cute looks to children?
No,
was he the same kind of person you are sitting and your brother is sitting in between, he gives those looks?
We went during the interval tried to meet him, and he immediately asked about my name and things like that,
and
my father introduced me to Panditji. And in fact, Guruji, he had met at Omkarji's residence, And then that was the time when he requested Guruji that could you come to our place to teach my wife.
Jogeshwari, I think.
Jogeshwari,
okay,
yeah.
Okay.
And he agreed. And I remember then he used to come twice a week, Tuesdays and Thursdays.
How many years was this on?
This went on for just 2 years.
And in this period, like once you had mentioned, he must have noticed you,
yeah,
and had called you.
I'll tell you what happened.
Like
in fact, I used to accompany my mother on tabla when Guruji taught her Natya Sangeet. Apart from Natya Sangeet, he used to teach his own compositions.
Knew the stylistics of the typical playing with the Natya
Sangeet? No. I was just providing him the teka, and I was not good at it. But I could at least provide the basic teka.
At that time, these things were not in the electronic tabla.
I think Guruji was generous enough to accept me and tolerate my presence.
You did not
there.
Know that at that time a click of that scene would have been quite a thing.
Yeah. But what used to happen was when I used to see Guruji teaching my mother, I used to observe the way he used to handle the instrument. The harmonium was synonymous with him.
Okay.
And I feel the only good thing about me then was I could visualize that this is something that I want to become.
Mm-hmm.
If at all I want to pursue music, I want to become someone like him,
mm-hmm,
who has such dedication for the instrument, his technique of touching the instrument, that
mm-hmm
itself, you know, that itself mesmerized me, in fact, because I had seen people play the harmonium before that,
mm-hmm,
in Madhukar Samanji's class, many of them,
mm-hmm,
and the way he handled it was so simple.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, that was what attracted me most. And then what I did was, when he used to teach a composition of his to my mother, Sahavasa Prema Maitri,
mm-hmm,
he had specific touches that he used to give, and I used to be intrigued by that, and I tried to actually follow that.
Okay.
And once my father, as a proud father, or any proud father would be, you know, he just told my Guruji, Sudhir also tries to play the harmonium, and can he accompany his mother? And I don't know what, how Guruji must have responded or reacted to that. But he said, being the generous person he is, he said, yes, of course. And
like
I,
now in front of me. That
Yeah, and I played that. And I played the typical touches that I had observed. And then that was the moment, I tell you, Nandini, he put his hand on my back just for a few seconds, but I still remember that touch, because that was the touch that changed me.
Okay.
And there was then no looking back. I was so mesmerized, because
he used to come home to teach you also.
Yeah.
That is for how long?
No, he did not teach me. Let me tell you, he did not teach me then. But he saw that I was interested in the harmonium, and he gave me two alankars or exercises, just two.
Practice exercises.
And I used to do that religiously.
Mm-hmm.
Meanwhile, I used to try to imbibe different aspects of Hindustani music through my listening,
mm-hmm,
through accompanying LP record players, especially Bismillah Khan Sahib Shehnai Dhun, I remember, Rageshri and one Dhun,
mm-hmm,
in Khamaj. That is the one that really attracted me. And I tried to reproduce those notes on the harmonium. And my father used to tell, yes, you can do it. So that is how he used to encourage me. And that created a confidence in me that I can do something in
parallelly,
this.
Parallelly, what was happening at school? Were you participating in competitions?
No, I was a very, very shy kid in school.
What about till 10th, 12th? Any kind of activity we can say that you were in the cultural scenario?
In fact, that is...
let's say till TY, what happens?
In 85... that is just 2 years after Guruji started coming to our place, we were transferred to Pune.
Mm-hmm.
And Bhimseni, in fact, we took some references from Guruji, and he told, why don't you meet Bhimseni and give my reference? Why don't you meet so and so persons? These are people known to me.
But then when did you learn from Guruji? You went
that,
to his
lessons? This is the story that I'm telling.
Okay,
So he gave me some references, and since my father wanted to continue this association with music,
mm-hmm,
he said we want to learn under some good gurus there.
Mm-hmm.
Fortunately, so happened that our neighbor, next door neighbor,
mm-hmm,
the quarters, Canada Bank quarters that we lived,
mm-hmm,
in, was a musician,
mm-hmm,
Mrs. Hema Gurjar,
mm-hmm,
who used to teach a lot of people. And I started constantly listening to what she taught throughout the day, and my mother used to learn from her. And my brother started learning the tabla from Shantilal Shah, the disciple of Pandit Suresh Tarwalkar. And I, of course, could not get formal guidance anymore. But the best part that happened, best thing that happened was, my Guruji used to visit Pune frequently for concerts. And then my father requested him, so why didn't you stay with us when you come here? And he gladly agreed. And then that is the time when actually my association increased. And I feel, you know.
So how long at a time do you remember learning from him? 1 hour, 2 hours?
No, it was again, that was not the time when I was learning from him. This was just the time when I started being actually inspired by him. And that was the time when I before that, I mean, from 85 to 87, I think 2 years, because that was the time when Guruji used to hardly visit, one or two visits in a year. But during those 2 years, I felt that I was missing Guruji so much. And that inspired me to learn more and more music through observation, through listening. And because this music class was right next door to us, I could grasp a lot of bandishes just by listening to them and knowing rag structures. So I had quite a good grasp and a basic swarajnan of what you call the basic swarajnan that you need to become a musician. I think I had that.
Had you given some exams also in between?
No, no. But once I came in contact with Mrs. Hema Gurjar, yes, I thought of giving exams also. And I gave some of the exams.
Just for vocals?
No, it was for harmonium.
Okay.
It was for harmonium. But I was not really learning harmonium, but I was trying to play bandishes which I had listened to on the harmonium. That was not really a trained kind
this
of.
This is Gandharva Vidyalaya, right?
This, yeah.
Okay.
Gandharva Vidyalaya. Then gradually.
Parallelly, you were attending concerts, even Savai Gandharva.
Yeah, I was.
So you must have seen some very good artists.
Yeah, yeah, that listening culture was never. You know,
and you were never like, oh, I have to stay awake, nothing like that. You would happily be awake all these 3 days.
By that time, we were accustomed to the whole scenario of listening to music. Because even when Guruji, from 83 to 85, those 2 years that we spent with Guruji in Mumbai, we constantly used to go to different concerts with Guruji, along with, we had a car and we used to take Guruji along with us, and for example the stalwarts like Pandit Mallikarjun Mansurji, Pandit Yashwant Bua Joshi, Prabhakar Karikar, or many of those people who Guruji used to accompany, we got a chance to learn, listen to.
I think even Padmavati Sharma.
No, that time he was not accompanying her. At least I have not heard him accompanying her. But we used to go to these concerts, and my younger brother and I had a reputation of sleeping in the concerts. And sometimes in the midst of the concert, I used to get up and see Guruji playing the same kind of a passage which the vocalist has sung and reproducing the same expression, which is what actually attracted me towards the accompanying part of harmony. So as an accompanying instrument, how does it sound? How does it perceive the vocalist? So that is what I was very much attracted.
Were you aware of the kinds of harmoniums and things?
No, I was not aware of anything.
Okay.
So that was just the period when I was trying to gauge how music can be.
Have you also been to Goa at that time?
No.
Because of Guruji's influence,
no,
or some festivals,
no,
or something.
No.
So it was Pune and Mumbai.
It was only Pune. And Mumbai, of course, once we shifted from Mumbai to Pune, it was mostly Pune. And as I said, later on Guruji started accompanying Bhimsenji. And that was precisely the time when he used to stay with us for a longer period. And that is.
That must be quite a number of times.
Yeah. In fact, very frequently. In fact, 4 or 5 times a month. So that what used to happen was, I used to make my own notes in my diary, and I used to ask him only those things which I found were not happening. Like if I was not comfortable playing a certain scale, I used to just ask him, and I used to ask him, how do you place your finger positions in a particular scale?
So after those 2 alankars, what has happened?
That is what this was happening. So I was studying and I was asking him whatever were the hurdles in my.
So he must have discovered you are a self-studying.
Then he must have thought that at least this boy can do something. That is why he was taking interest.
How many were the, like, you have some Guru Panthos and Bhaginis, who else were learning from you there?
I really was not associated with a single Guru Bhai or Guru Bhai.
So you were the first one? I think the
there were people. I never knew about the tradition of having Guru Bhais or Guru Bhai.
Because Seema and others have come later?
They came in 85. But again, I was not associated with them because they were in Mumbai.
And you were the same boy, like when you were doing all this, you know, the boy, typical, this boy in shorts and like.
Yeah, of course.
So he must have looked at you as a child.
Yeah, of course.
This child has interest in music.
Yeah, and first of all, when he saw me, I don't know, but because he must have teaching, he must have taught me music or taken interest in imparting some knowledge only because my father was very much interested in that. But later on, when he actually observed that I am taking keen interest in music, then he thought of actually teaching me. But it could not happen in a systematic way at that time, because we never had a long-standing association of learning, which usually happens. Tutelage usually starts from a particular rag or alankar, and then the systematic progression that you have, that we could never actually experience. Then it so happened that I used to go to some vocalist to a company. There was one Jayant Vatve, a brother of Madhav Vatve and Purnima Talwalkar, who I used to go to a company, and I could learn some of the achop rags and aprachalit rags from this association. That was for about a year and a half. After that, I started going to Pandit Jitendra Abhisheki. Abhisheki Bua was so generous to accept me. I never went there as a student of music. I just went there to observe how a Gurukul tradition works. That was my intention. And he and his family were very generous to accept me as a member of the family. In fact, I became almost a member of the family. And without knowing, I never realized how I become part of the family and started accompanying Abhisheki ji after some time. So that association went on till 98, in fact, for 10 long years. So in 88, I went to Pandit Abhisheki ji, and till 98, I was with Abhisheki. In between, my Guruji told me that you can't actually learn here living in Pune. So it's better you come to Mumbai often. So happened that so I went to Abhisheki ji, and without realizing, I actually started accompanying him, because there was such an association that I used to accompany his disciples, and then I used to accompany a lot more people in Pune, and gradually I got to know the intricacies of classical music, of rag sangeet especially, through what Abhisheki ji taught.
You and Guruji were not like face to face sitting and doing.
No, we were doing that, but it was not like a systematic tali that should have happened.
But he
used to guide me. He used to tell me how a particular pad should be played, an Natya Sangeet should be played. In fact, that was the time when, in fact, I got to learn a lot about tuning, because we used to have so many harmoniums come to our place, and they used to land up somehow, and many of the reputed musicians used to just keep harmoniums and say, whenever Guruji comes to your place, tell him to tune this harmonium. And my Guruji used to do that.
And what age you came to know this harmonium? Like, tell us about kinds of harmoniums.
No, but then due to Guruji's long-standing association, I gradually asked him questions, and he used to answer me all those questions. And gradually, I used to ask him questions about types of harmonium. And he being not only a harmonium player, but a person who has explored the instrument as a whole, he used to let me know of the different kinds of harmoniums that exist, like a scale change harmonium, or let's say a the reed organ or vertically placed harmonium or horizontally placed harmonium. So there are different kinds of harmoniums in band. So
you went to buy an additional harmonium, or you had a couple of them, three
that
or
was,
four?
No, I had only one harmonium that I we had purchased for my mother, and my first.
This you always took with you for a concert?
I took that harmonium for my concerts, but then I bought another harmonium in 1988 from D.S. Ramsingham Brothers in Mumbai. This was because Abhisheki ji used to have two harmonium players for some theme based program that he used to conduct.
Mm-hmm.
And I used to be sitting on the other side of the stage, not where the regular harmonium
mm-hmm.
players sits. So that the other singers can get a good feedback from the harmonium accompaniment. So that actually helped me a lot.
And you have to tell us about after your 10th, what was the educational thing? What did you do?
After my 10th, I did my commerce.
Okay. So that was from which college? And
also
you haven't
Garhwali
mentioned
college.
Your schools.
My first school was in Uttar Pradesh. It was the Nannamal English Medium School, after which I never remember having gone to a nursery or a kindergarten or even standard first. I was directly admitted to second class because they thought I had done my schooling at home, so to say. My mother had taught me a lot of things. And
so what was your next school?
After Nannamal, I came to Mumbai. I did my third standard at home only because there was so many riots in UP. So I just attended the second and partly the third standard in UP. Then fourth standard, of course, again in UP. I was there for 6 months. Then we got transferred to Mumbai, and I came to King George, which was Raja Shivaji.
It was a good school.
Yeah, and I
that went, was how many years?
That was just for a year.
Okay.
After that, I went to Ansaraj Moraji Public School in Andheri.
That's for how many years?
That was for around 5 years.
So where did you do your 10th?
Then I did my matriculation in Pune.
Okay, so quite a number of schools.
Yeah, exactly. So Pune, we were transferred to Pune. That was my year of matriculation. And that was the time when we were transferred to Pune. And there was a lot of burden because it was a new place and things like that. Our affinity towards music was there, very much predominant in the family.
So, what about your 12th? Which college have you?
After my 10th, passing my 10th, I took admission in Garhwali College of Commerce.
Mm-hmm.
I did my commerce.
So, how was the mahal or what was the place like for music and for cultural activities?
Culturally, there was one section called Rasik Mandal. Of course, because of my association with Abhisheki ji, I was made secretary of Rasik Mandal.
Where did you catch the funny side? Like some people say, if you start saying jokes, you just can say jokes for 2 hours. Where does that come from?
That I think
is it hereditary? What is it?
No, I had
then
this.
Is your brother like you?
Yeah, he's very much like me.
Funny.
And we both have affinity for telling jokes, and we really enjoy that process, and that I think
so
that
where this particular thing has begun, and when did you start actually telling jokes
it
and entertaining
never,
the was that happening in college also?
Yes, of course. Yes.
So you were a very favorite, like
Sudhiraya. No, not
now,
really. I was popular amongst my friends for my jokes. Not really, but I was a very shy person.
Was that just a joke, or was that what has come later, like you act it and people think it is real?
Those facets developed later, much later.
Okay.
In fact, maybe during my travel and things like that. Because
you need a place to sit, and you are acting, and then you get a place to sit.
Yes, of course. I love those things.
Real tales.
Yes, there are many anecdotes that are. I mean, many anecdotes that are related to the
and then,
vast journey that I've gone
during
through.
Your FYSYT, where you had youth fests, and were you a participant?
I was not really involved in those things because I was. I used to bunk my college to go to Abhishekiji's place. So
and is there a corner in your house where maybe there are a couple of medals and off the college
not
days?
Not really. To be honest, I've never even competed. In any
and
of the
about after your graduation,
after
have you pursued your com or have you pursued something?
No,
like
I started doing law after my commerce. After doing my bachelor's
so
in commerce.
So because you were very funny, suddenly you decided to be serious.
No. It was not like that. My grandfather wanted one lawyer in the family. He was very much attracted towards law.
Oh, so you have done this continuously, no break?
No break.
Okay, so you just finished off with your law and very nicely.
No, I took break for 1 year because I had to decide what I had to do. Because after my bachelor's in commerce, I was already in music and I was playing with a lot of
people. Did
you
mention your college?
Garbhari College.
Okay, Garbhari. So that's from 11th till your...
Till
5 years.
Yeah, 5 years. And after that, I went to ILS Law College. And
was there any subject like some language or something that had scope for, you know, did you have some compulsory English or Hindi?
Yes, we had
That is for FYSY?
For FYSY, we had English.
Okay.
So, but I had
schooling in UP has helped you in some way? Somewhere, something.
Any experience
the
that you have...
The language part of it.
Any experience that you have helps yes. in some way or the other. Environment that was in UP, it's very different from what we
you
have now.
You actually can think like you can just go in that area like a child and
yes,
you can
I do imagine those
travel
things.
And come back.
I want to do that some point of time. At some point of time. Because those memories are really strong in my...
So what happens after your college days?
After my college, of course, I had decided to pursue this career. I did law only for the sake of
you
my
haven't
satisfaction.
Practiced.
No, I never practiced. I did not complete my law. Because, you know, I remember the
but
second
do you
year.
Think it made you wiser? Kind of.
Any, as I told you, any thing that you study certainly adds to your intellect and
okay.
your way of thinking, your perception.
Yes, yes, yes.
So it must have.
People will say, in se panga nahi lena chahiye. Inhone law kiya hua hai.
The kaida in music is very different than than in actual practice. So basically,
have you gone for a job or something in between?
Never.
Maybe for a small time.
Never. My father insisted me to do something parallel to this, and so I took up a job as an insurance agent for some time. But I used to insure policies for musicians.
Okay.
So many of the musicians were helped me out and gave me policies.
That was life insurance.
Life insurance, yeah, LIC. But I did not.
You didn't take a policy for yourself.
I did.
At that time.
Yeah, so I could get commission through that. But it did not continue for long because it so happened that I was traveling a lot and I could not pursue all these things.
Mm-hmm.
My travel really increased a lot. I used to accompany a lot of musicians.
Mm-hmm.
And in 91, I went to the US with Abhishekji for around 3.5 months.
Mm-hmm.
That was a lot of experience. I got a lot to learn from those trips.
Mm-hmm.
And after I returned from the US, that was the time when I seriously decided to go to Guruji to learn harmony.
Because of Abhishekji Bua, you must have been to Goa also a couple of times.
Yeah, I used to go to
and
Goa.
And you have seen Mangeshi properly?
Yes, of
and
course.
Also stayed?
Of course.
Which means you have
stayed
stay very
with
close to my grandparents' residence over there.
Yeah. So okay. I have been fortunate to see that.
And the big Tulsi Vrindavan.
Yeah, of course. I have been witness to all those things, the activities, the festivals that happen in Mangeshi temple.
And that
many
time the Palki used to have singers also, I think,
yeah,
singing.
Exactly. That is a part
and
of the
And Ramnavami will have the plays, Sangeet Nataks.
I believe so, yeah. So, but I was certainly associated with the Goan culture a lot because of Abhishekji ji's and
So have you been to a lot of these fests which had musical activities?
Yes.
By any chance you have seen Goa's father also?
No, never.
Because maybe he passed.
He passed away a long time.
Because
so
my
not.
Mom mentions that he was a very big singer,
yeah,
very
yes.
great kid.
Balboa Abhishekji. But I could not ever see him. After 91, when I decided to go to Mumbai to learn from Guruji, I told Guruji that I want to have a systematic training because I was missing that. Although I used to accompany a stalwart like Abhishekji, I felt the need of. I felt the need of. A systematic training in harmony. So that was the time when Guruji said, okay, we'll start with one rag. And he started with Kafi. I said, no, I want to start from Saregama Pa, from the beginning. And he said, you're already playing harmony. I said, that's not the thing. I want to start a discipline.
It's very rare for a student to say that.
But
because people really wish to jump steps.
I honestly felt that. So then gradually we started learning and then the learning process started. from Guruji.
Mm-hmm.
And then there was no looking back because I used to visit his place almost every day. Sometimes
you were old enough to travel alone.
Yeah, that's right. That was one of the things that gave me the confidence.
And has it happened that like some of us, you have stayed and like, okay,
yes,
next day you were back?
Rarely, but I used to be there the day long and I used to go home at 1 in the morning sometimes. So
it's a nice thing because whoever has stayed with him has had the opportunity to have the nice delicacies
of course,
that Kaki used to cook.
Mommy used to
And very affectionately. And she'll think, how hard he's working, give him a break.
I think this is one thing, when you stay with, although we were not staying in the Guru's residences, the Gurukul system was existing, even during that time. Even today, it is existent in some of the places. Although you're not staying with the Gurus, you spend time with the Gurus, and which is
And you
which is
actually
most important.
Know with one look, he's angry, he's happy,
exactly.
What he wants to say.
Because it's a long association. It's a very intimate association. And here is where the
and
family...
And he had retired from his job at that time, or was
he... had retired from his services in 88. So he had retired during that time. But it was a very long-standing association that started then.
Mm-hmm.
And... I should say the generosity of the people living with him, the family members, is something that should be acknowledged by every seeker, every student who goes to such people.
So
because
this was how long? Maybe 8 to 10 years.
It's on.
At that time as a student, how much time?
I think it continued.
At least
till,
at Bakul, I think.
Till about 2005, I was a regular...
Was that at Malad or was that at Bakul?
No, that was at Bakul. I never went to Malad except for a couple of times.
Okay.
But Malad was the place where other Guru Bhais used to come.
So this was still, at least till 2005?
2005. Okay. I continued learning from him and I still continue, but it's not regular. It may be year or once in... 6 months.
Yeah.
But all the same, we try to communicate. See, it's not the formal training that I'm talking about. That formal training certainly existed till 2005. But after that, these 10 years, we have tried and gained so much from him. We have tried to learn whatever we can from him. Not only me, my other Guru Bhais, we have always seen him as a person who is a storehouse of knowledge. And we try to seek everything that he has, his presence, his attitude of being in the music field, his attitude towards life, his perception of an accompanying musician, everything, each and everything that
he
possesses.
I want to ask you about some of the awards that you got, and let's say some of the prestigious concerts and festivals that you played for, whether it is in India or outside, and the vows that you got, the first very, some that you got for whatever you played, whether it's from Guru, a real one, not the typical vows that come in every concert, but something you thought that yes, I know I did something good and yes, it has come.
In fact,
a couple of them.
There have been so many instances, as I said.
So recent is after your maturity, but when you started playing the first 10 years, definitely it must.
Of course, there
were
so many people who used to encourage me.
This is about some musicians, I want. Someone who must have said,
"Ki, aaj aapne kya bajaya?" I should honestly tell one thing. I mean, it's with great humility that I tell, but I should admit that any of the, I mean, not many, in fact, each and every person, I should say, who I got a chance to interact with, to accompany, has blessed me.
Okay.
And even those artists who I played, the stalwarts like Pandit Bhim Sen Joshi ji. Pandit Jitendra Vishwaji, of course, was my guru. He was the one who used to actually, I used to be very afraid of him because he would never appreciate openly.
Mm-hmm.
Although he had a very soft
heart. And the conversation used to go in Konkani?
Yes, even on stage.
So you had such difficulty in understanding one Konkani for a while?
Not at all. I
slowly you picked
I had a passion for the language.
Okay.
And I picked up. Also quite
and
good.
I
in
used
fact,
to
many,
think he
many
spoke Marathi.
No, I used to speak Konkani with me.
And in family it was Marathi?
In family
okay,
it was
okay.
Marathi. And
have you seen him composing and
yes,
rehearsing
that was
for
one
his
experience,
plays and all
that?
That
was one
great.
Experience I had. In fact, the first project that I worked with him was for a project of Mahabharata. written by a person in America. And you know, the first few days, I should narrate this, when he got the script, he used to just see it and abuse the script and then throw the papers away. And I used to be ready with the harmonium, only Abhishekji and me and no one else. He used to call me every afternoon at around 3:30, and I used to take the harmonium and sit there. And nothing would happen for the next 3-4 hours, nothing would happen, and then he would say, let's start with this bandish, and he would practice, and I would accompany him on the tabla. So I said, what is happening? 5 or 6 days, I'm just going there and nothing happening. When is he going to compose this? And then one day, he said, we'll go to the vegetable market and buy something. And I went on a Metador. He used to own a Metador van. And Arvind Pedgaonkar had come that day. And he used to, you know, because he was a very old disciple and a friend, so to say. So they were talking some things, and I was just sitting behind them listening to their talks when we were going in the van. And he suddenly told me, I said, what is this? Out of the blue this comes in. I immediately gauged that it's Dhani. What does he want to say? He said, remember this scale. I said, okay, fine. Next day we went there, and the first song came out, the same scale. So the wordings were Ghana Ghor Yuddha Udhavale. So I was just, meanwhile, I was just trying to gauge how he would set tune to that particular piece. And then he came.